If I have a quarter circle line of uniform charge, so I have a linear charge density that is uniform, so dQ dL would be equal to the total charge, which I'm going to label cleverly as Q, over this length here, L. It is part of a semicircle, so the distance from this central point here where I want to find the electric field to the line of charge is R. I know, and so what I want to find here is I want to find the electric field at this point and the potential at this point. Now, since I can establish zero to be anywhere I want it to be, I could officially make it zero and be done with it, but that would really spoil the purpose of what I'm trying to do here. And so we will establish that V is equal to zero at R is equal to infinity, which is the most common way of doing that. And so I need to figure out what the electric field is here. Now, I know that the electric field is ultimately going to be in that direction, where that is a 45 degree angle here because of symmetry arguments. You can go through the math and do the whole thing, but really all I need to do is just solve for one component, and I have the other one. Establish our convention here. Let's go with the typical brainwashed version of it. Now I need to establish some temporary variables. Well, I need to establish a dQ. And the electric field from dQ is going to be in that direction. I will establish an angle here of theta. And so what I'm going to do is just find the I component of my electric field, and then I'll know what the J component is. Do recognize that it will be in the negative J direction. So my differential in the I direction, little subscript I here, is going to be equal to my electrostatic constant times dQ over R squared times the sine of theta I hat. And sine of theta, because I'm looking at this component in that direction, and that would be the opposite of my angle theta. So my electric field in the I direction is going to be the integral of KE dQ over R squared sine theta I hat. Now I can bring the constants out. I know KE is constant. That it's called the electrostatic constant or Coulomb's constant, so that can come out. I know that I hat is constant, so that can come out. I know that R squared is constant in this case, unlike some of the other ones that we do, because the distance from anywhere along this line of charge to the point in question is going to be the same distance, so that is constant. And so what I'm left with is just dQ sine theta. I need to get it in terms of a single variable. Well, from this relationship right here, I know that dQ is equal to lambda dL. And so that's equal to KE I hat over R squared. Lambda is constant, so it's going to come out. So lambda integral of dL sine theta. Doesn't quite help us yet. But dL is the distance along here. It's this differential of length along the line right here. So if I look at that, where this distance here is dL, this angle right here would be the differential of the angle, so this would be d theta. And then using the classic relationship between arc length and angle, I know that dL is equal to r d theta. And so I can now plug that in here. So I get k e I hat lambda over r squared times r d theta sine theta. That R is going to cancel out with one of those. And now I have it the integral in terms of a single variable. And so, well, theta is going to go from 0 to that angle right there, which is pi over 2. My electric field in the I direction is going to be, I'm just rewriting what I had written down before. Integral of sine theta is negative cosine theta, so I have negative k e lambda I hat over r. So that would be negative, already have the negative right there, cosine theta from 0 to pi over 2. Plug in that you get 0, so this becomes 0 minus 1. So that's negative 1, which cancel out with that. So I'm left with the ke lambda I hat over r. We do get a positive value here in the end, which is what I would expect because it is in the positive I hat direction. And so my total electric field at that central point is going to be ke lambda over r I hat minus ke lambda over r j hat. And so that is the electric field at that particular point. Now find the electric potential at that point. It's a little bit simpler. Going back to the original drawing here. Again, I establish my dq and my temporary angles. Actually, I don't need the angle because direction does not matter here. I'm not breaking this up into components. I know that for a point charge, v is equal to kq over r. But in this particular case, since I'm taking this particular spot right there, my differential of my potential is k dq over r. So my potential is the integral of k dq over r. We bring out the constants here. K comes out. R is constant for the same reason as it was before, and we're left with dq. So this just becomes, and my k is changing as I go, but we're just going to deal with it. So I have my k over r times q. Technically, I'm integrating from 0 to q, that when I'm here, that there is no charge, total charge, and as I move along this way, my total charge increases. And so this is the same thing as the electric potential from a point charge a distance r away. So that was a whole lot simpler.